And there we are, back at that opening arpeggiated flourish. Well, yes and no. The thematic material, as it's called, is the same in this next section, but there are lots of little changes along the way. This time, the answering motif is taken by the violin alone, while the viola and cello play a pure accompaniment with a repetitious duple rhythm, da-ya-ta-ta-da-ya-ta-ta, and so on. But apart from the violin, this passage, as far as the strings are concerned, really belongs to the double bass, which has a lovely but very discreet alternation of spelt-out chords, first pizzicato, plucked, then bowed. Either way, the effect is rather percussive, almost like a muffled kettle drum. Again and again, tone quality is a prime element in this piece.